Welcome. Welcome, class. All right, we're doing a fundraiser today, and why I'm here and why I'm donating my time is for Enlightened Kingsport. And some of you might have heard, I know Ms. Robinson's heard a little bit about that already, but Enlightened Kingsport is sponsored by the Freedom Family Worship Center. It's down here on Center Street, just a couple streets, one street over. And they are trying to do a service project for the community and build and just do things that need to be done around here. So we're going to donate this class to them. Go to you. All right. And I love them. I love the Lord. And so this is His work. So now why I got into yoga was because I was going through a divorce. And go ahead and stretch while I was in here. I was going through a divorce, and I had pretty much stopped taking care of my body. I had an emotional breakdown, and I basically was just falling apart. And I met someone who did yoga, and he looked, at about 65, he looked better than 20-year-olds. I couldn't believe it. I could not believe it. I was just like, what are you doing? And then you can stretch back and just come forward about a few times. So I couldn't believe what in the world he was doing that made him look so much younger, even than me. I was 20 years his youth, right? Okay, let's stretch our legs apart here. I found out he was doing yoga. And while I was just hanging around him, he started just talking to me about it and sharing it. Right now, we're just doing some basic stretches just to warm our body up. Some of us have been sitting at a desk all day long.
Forever a day.
Right. And while I was watching him and hanging with him and I started doing the yoga, I started seeing like really awesome things in my body happen. I started feeling better for the first time in a very long time. Now, one thing, we're going one more time over to this. One thing I didn't mention while we're stretching is how important breathing is, okay? So while I'm talking, I'm not doing proper breathing, but you, everybody in here, you can focus on your breathing. I'll just go ahead and take both our arms up, deep breath in, and exhale and lean forward. And if you can't come all the way down, just come to your elbows or your hands. That's okay, come where you need to. Yeah, you can even take your block. That's why we put the blocks there. Then you can put your block in front of you.
My legs will come.
That's okay. That's normal. Because they're not used. You can bring them in. That means they're probably out too far. So you bring them in where it's comfortable. You can get them flat. And then you just focus on relaxing forward. Let that breath go. Do a cat stretch, kind of walk our back up. And then we're going to bring our shoulders back. And down. One more time. Up. And back. And down. And waking everything up. It's been probably compressed while you're on a computer, you know, because we're like this all day long. Okay, one more time. Up. And back. All right. Now while we're here, let's just go ahead and bring one leg, doesn't matter which one. I'm bringing my right one, bring it in. We're going to turn our upper body so that we're facing that leg that's out. All right. You don't have to worry about touching it, but what you can do is you can grab your strap. Straps are handy. Now, I want you to know, for the people that are watching this, I bought these straps, but we make straps. We crochet them and we sell them here in the studio because we support the local arts. So anyway, you'll take your strap, wrap around your leg, and then you can just kind of lean into it where it feels comfortable, right there. Now, one thing we like to do if you're doing hatha yoga is you stay in a position, sometimes longer than you want to. While you're right there, I'm going to come around. I'm going to show you what, if you have assisted yoga, which is what I like to have with a lot of my classes. They're small. Somebody comes in and just barely pushes you. Can you feel the difference of that? Right, just a little bit. Now, when you're ready, you can release that leg and go ahead and switch your legs out and go to the other side. And it really, I just barely touched you, but that little bit is enough. All right, and then you align your body, get your strap, all right? Take a deep breath, and when you exhale, I'm gonna bring my arms up, you don't have to. On your exhale, you're gonna lean into that leg. And you're gonna relax and breathe. While you're relaxing, I'm gonna turn our music up a little bit. You stay right there. Also, I thought it would be kind of neat to listen to one of our local artists. Dan Banks Band. Okay, Pam, you can go ahead and come up. And keep your feet, we're going to go ahead, both feet out this time. And the strap, if you want to use it, I'm using it too because it's been a long time since I stretched. And then you just lean forward. And try to release, put your focus on your lower back where it goes right into your sit bones. You just want to really focus on that and relax as you're breathing. Now eventually you're going to try to get your forehead down to your knee. And when you're ready, you can come up slowly, kind of doing a cat roll, gentle on your back, shoulders up. And shoulders back. All right, let's go ahead and come to our feet. And we'll do a little stretching at the end as well. All right, so you're gonna come to the front of your mat. I'm gonna face this way just so you can see me. You can face this way, that'll do. All right, so you're gonna stand straight. When you're standing, even when you're standing straight, now my legs, I've got big legs, so you try to get them as close together as you can. You want your big toes to kind of touch if they can. And again, my legs won't do it, but if you can get your heels to touch, great. If you can't, just get them as close as you can. You want to be comfortable, but you want your weight evenly distributed. It actually makes a difference. And if you sit here and you just like kind of feel, am I leaning, am I teetering, or am I evenly distributed? Your big toes kind of grip into the ground. That's your balance, right? Okay. So while you're standing here, you've got your grip. Kind of getting your upper body kind of loose, right? You want to work with your alignment. We won't go this slow all the time, but you kind of also want to work with your alignment. Sometimes our backside has a tendency to go out. You want to kind of roll it in, right? That kind of that straightens you out. Now again, you've got your feet. There's a lot of things that are going on. Very dynamic. You've got your feet, your legs are engaged, your gluteus maximus is engaged. As we're coming up the body, your stomach is now going to be engaged. You're coming up, your shoulders are back. You're standing straight, your head, you want your focus to be straight ahead. All right, this is just for the first pose, just for the standing pose. All right, we're ready? We're going to raise our arms up. Lift up, just stand right here for a second. You're holding that breath in. Exhale, arms come down. And we'll just bring them to our front. I forgot to say, a lot of we like to dedicate our yoga to something, and I was gonna pray before I got started, and again, I'm going out of step, but I forgot. So while we're doing this, everybody's got things that are going on. I'm praying and dedicate this to this Enlightened Kingsport. But I want each of you to find something as you're doing yoga that you can kind of like pray and send positive energy to. So that's, we're gonna keep our hands. When we come to our poses, we will finish like up in a prayer position. So arms are gonna come up, deep breath in. Look up if you like. This time you can lean back. Come back forward, straight up. Exhale, arms come down slowly and then back to our prayer. Okay, stay right here. Starting to warm up now. Deep breaths. You'll start sweating quick now. Put the pot. Deep breath in. This time we're going to lean forward. Your arms are going to come out to the side. Very slow and controlled. You're going to come down. Exhale. Hands to the floor if you can do it. If you can't, you can just touch your shins. You can touch above your knees. Wherever's comfortable. Eventually you want to touch the floor and just hang over right here. Now, I'm going to come around to you. When you're hanging right there, go ahead and stay as far as you can. Here's something we can do. You can come behind. You can stay as far as you can. Keep those legs as far as you can. And just a little pressure right there. And don't take much. And you're ready. Go ahead slowly. Come back up. Arms above the head. And down, release to the side. Everything again, legs are tight, gluteus maximus tight, arms are tight. Alright, we keep adding on to this, so it's starting to build up. We'll go faster now, okay? I'm going to sweep my hands down, and then up. We're going to lean forward. We're going to step the right leg back. Left leg stays in the front. Your hands are side to side of it. Legs out. No, as far as you can. And I'll tell you something else. What you can do, if that's not comfortable, can you look up here? I'm looking at it. If that's not comfortable, you can always even like put your leg perpendicular. And then if you come to the other side of your knee, it gives you a little bit more balance, okay? This is actually a little bit harder to hold. But again, if you really push that heel back, you can start to feel it in your leg. Now, what we're going to do is we're just going to switch our legs. We're starting slow. We're going to bring this leg back. And left leg is going to go out now. Now, while you're even here, your fingers are just barely touching the floor. Most of the pressure going to be right here on this front foot and on that back heel. Can you feel it? Okay. I'm going to hold it right here for a second. And now let's bring that back foot front. And let's lean over again. Take a deep breath right here. Let it out. On your next breath, we're going to come up. Arms are going to come out and up. All the way up, stretch. Down. And then come back into your prayer. Always keeps us focused. Okay, we're going to keep building on it. Alright, we're doing good. Alright, deep breath in, arms going down. You can swoop this time and then up. That engages your legs. This time let's lean back a little bit. Drop your arms back. And come back center. Slowly let's go over. Don't forget, each movement has a breath. You're in and you're out. All right, right leg is going to step back. Left leg is going to step back. We're going to be up in a plank position. Top of a push-up. And I tell you, if you can't do a push-up, you can come down to your knees. And then you can come down. If you can, you want your body to be straight. And then you want to come down. And then we're going to push up. This is the up dog right here. You can come up. Yeah. See if you can come all the way down to the floor.
I've done that too while you've been talking.
Good. Okay, wait, come all the way down. Good for you. That's good. That's good. All right, so right here, you're going to stay right here for a second. Your forehead will touch the floor. This will be a relax, a little break. And then we're going to push with our hand. Push up, look up. This is called an up dog.
What am I looking for?
depends on, like, if I just did this, if I engage just my stomach, that's where you're at, right here is COVID. There's no wrong. I'm pushing with my arm to just come up a little further. It's helping my back. The only thing, okay? All right, so then we're gonna tuck our toes under, and then we're gonna push back. This is the down dog. Now this, you wanna look almost like a triangle. Eventually, you want you want the back of your heels on the floor, mine or not, but we're working for it.
Now
you're fine.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
I can't do it.
They do a lot of hands-on, so when you're down these positions, even in a resting position, like I can pull you back like this. As you're pushing forward, you can lean forward and I'll push you back and it stretches your spine. Can you feel that? Yeah. Go ahead and try to push. You're going to push up again, so you're going to come up on your knees. Back and then try to do that down dog again. My hands are about shoulders width apart. My head drops down and I'm actually looking up at my belly button. My hands are pushing away from the floor and the back of my heels are trying to go down. Can you feel that? Mm-hmm. When you're ready, go ahead and drop back to your knees and then push back into the child's pose. What we were doing a second ago, just what you were doing, you're pushed all the way back with your hands forward and your head on the floor, your forehead on the floor. This is what we would call child's pose. Now, if you can, eventually you're pushing back, you try to get your buttocks on your heels. You want to be back put. Yeah, exactly. There you go. Can you feel the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now when you're ready, go ahead and come up on your knees. This time we're literally going to do the cat and the cow. So we're going to take a breath, right? Deep breath. You're looking up. You're extending your stomach. When you exhale, you're pulling it all in. Curving your back. Inhaling. Looking up. Exhaling, pushing and pulling it together. One more time. And release, pull it together. All right, you're gonna tuck your toes under. Go ahead and push back into your plank position. Do you remember that? The top of the push-up. You want your body down, almost straight to the floor, parallel to the floor if you can. And let's come all the way down, slow. One more time, push up. Up dog. That's okay. And back into child's pose one last time. But this shows you, this is exactly where you start, right? We are challenged. All right, we're gonna come back onto our hands and our knees. We're gonna take that right foot, swing it forward. Kind of pull it up, so only your heels touching. See if you can feel the pull. Mm-hmm. I can feel it all the way even to my back now. I'm gonna just lower my head, if I can, as far as I can, to my knee. And this, of course, is a lot easier on us than being standing up. Feel your muscles all the way in your leg. Now we're going to just switch legs very slowly, gently. Switch our legs. And we're going to lean our head forward. Breathe. Breathing slowly. All right, this time, and you're gonna tuck that back foot under. You're gonna come up, and we're gonna swing it up here into the front. And there you go. Pull yourself in a little tighter. And let's come up, arms out. And release. All the way down. And a prayer. All right. Build on it. We should sell sweat rags too, right? It's like it's hot. All right, we're going to build on it. We're going to scoop down. Come up. Lean back. Arms back. Good spine stretch. And center. Slowly come down. Relax right here. Take a deep breath. Keep those legs straight. Engage your quadriceps. Okay, right leg back. We're going to add something different this time. Take your left hand, bring it in front to the inside portion of your leg. Your back leg goes perpendicular, so now it's going to go sideways. And your other right arm is going to come up. This is strength building. Your legs are pushing away from the floor. Your arm, now you stay that pose right there. I'm going to come around. I'm going to give you just a little gentle assist and you'll feel. You feel a difference. When you're ready, go ahead and bring both hands down and feet back. Try to get as many push-ups in as we can. Good upper body.
You don't come back up.
No, I don't come up. You don't come up at all. You're just going down. That's, yeah. And then go ahead and do your up dog. Stretches the back the other direction. Okay, toes under. We're going to push back down dog. This time the right leg comes forward. Got two hands. Okay, you got that right hand, it comes to the inside of your leg. Back foot switches, there you go. And then the arm comes up. You want your body to be in one line, from the front foot all the way back. Now, I'm gonna show you something, see if you can see this. When I'm, my front foot right here, my heel should line up almost right here in the middle of my foot. And that's how you can get your alignment on where you're supposed to be. That helps. Mine's more to the outside because of my stride. But then I'm leaning. You've got a straight knee. Arms down. And again, you work into these things. And if you can, look up toward the ceiling. All these different things going, all these muscle groups are working together just so we can do this. Okay, hands back down to the floor. And front foot's gonna go back. Top of the push-up, you're gonna come down slow. Now again, bring your butt down a little bit, get yourself straight, parallel to the floor, and then come down slow. And then push up. Toes under. Ready to push back into the down dog. And from here, I can't do this gracefully, but at some point we will. You can jump forward or step forward. They make it look so pretty. Mine are not so pretty. One more time. Pull yourself in, stretch. And arms up, coming up. And release. I am seriously going to get me a, do you want a band-aid, like a sweat rag? Okay. I'm going to get that off. It's a little warm. Can you feel anything? Okay. Well, it's warm in here for sure. Okay.
I turned the fan on a little bit.
Let's go. All right, so here's the sun salutation is the basics for the first flow. They have a series, okay? Kind of like if you're in karate and you learn katas, I think they're called katas, your different series of movements. So with yoga, they have the sun salutation, which is what we've been doing. Arms up, down, step back, you know, push up, down, up dog, down dog, and then back up. That's like a whole sequence, right? So then we start adding on to it and making it a little bit more challenging if we want to work on, you know, there's four poses. Have you been to yoga before? Okay. Well, here's this sidebar. Sidebar. There's standing series, and then there's floor series, right? And then there's breathing that goes through all of it. When you're doing some movements, it's automatic. You feel you've got to breathe in, right? It would not feel right to go, right? You have to breathe in. Some movements you have to breathe out. All right, well, some movements, like this is called the tree pose. These are balanced. So you've got strength and you've got balance. So this is, you can do it. We'll come back to it that I've shown you. So this is a simple pose. You bring your leg up, right, eventually. If you need, you can hold it. You can have one hand up. You can have both hands up. You can have hands up above your head. You can have hands out to the side. I mean, you know what I mean? Even just doing this, you work. I'm using my right leg. You can feel the muscles as you're just trying to stay. Yeah, right? It's going all the way up. My leg. Okay, so that is just let's do the other side, just make it even. But right now we're doing a lot of combination standing and floor. We did some floor when we began, and we'll do some balance. That works different muscles as they come together. Whoa, it's okay though. You fall out, just get back. And it helps to look at one spot, I will tell you that. If you find something, and one side is generally harder than the other. That is true for everybody. You really pull those arms out, almost like I'm going to come to show you. You stay right there. Good. Okay. Yeah. So go back. I'm just going to show you what it feels like though. Get back in your tree. Okay. I should come here for a second. This is your first time doing. I get a wall. I don't even know why I thought that, right? So you come to the wall. The other one, right? But this is perfect. This is fine. Right? And then when you can, just let go. And I was just going to pull your arm just a little bit when you're out of the wall. When you pull those, you can feel the extension even in your back. Okay. All right. So that's one of our balance poses, which everybody loves, the tree pose. I mean, it's pretty, there's a lot. I mean, there's the dancer's pose, and you're standing here out. Those are beautiful. And it works as you're pulled from your little toes that are gripping the ground all the way up. So, all right, we're going to go back to sun salutations and build, though, because we're doing strength. So, stand up straight. It's tucked in. Feet right on that floor. We're going to scoop down. Look back, lean back, put your arms back, back to center, and forward. Just stay right here, relax. Right leg comes back, Yeah, tricky, tricky. Here we go. Next, arms are going to come up, and we're going to come into a warrior. Okay, feel that.